This video will go over the site settings page within PlantLog. This is a section that requires administrative privileges, so to access it, you will need to sign into the web application using a desktop web browser. Finally, we have the site settings page, and this provides you to change a few overarching behaviors of the software that will affect your entire PlantLog account. So the only two I want to mention here are the top two. This first one here says automatically set item to last most recent value, and you can see the description shown here in black. And what that means is that anytime an operator goes to input data on an item within a log, it will automatically default that value to the last value taken. So for example, if the evap pressure for that chiller number one that we created earlier was recorded at 75 PSI yesterday, then that value will default to 75. And this allows an operator to simply confirm that that value is still at the same pressure reading, or he can make adjustments as needed and then move on. But it does help them speed up data entry when values are do not change very often, because the person doesn't have to re-enter that value very often. However, it can promote what we might call pencil whipping, where an operator might be tempted to sort of breeze through the item values because they're being defaulted for him, and not actually look at the value more carefully. So depending on your preference, you can set it to yes or no. It defaults to yes. And the next option says only use encrypted barcode tags. And here's that explanation there in black. And this also defaults to yes. And what this means is that if it is defaulted to yes, you can only use the barcode tags provided by PlantLog. You cannot use your own asset tagging system, because the PlantLog barcode tags include encrypted characters to prevent counterfeiting. And this is sort of extra insurance to ensure that the operators are scanning official barcodes placed on the assets rather than, well, it could be just an incorrect barcode. You might have other barcodes on that asset for other reasons. And just for extra verification that they are in fact physically in front of that asset. If, however, you want to use your own barcoding system with PlantLog, you would have to set this setting to no. And that will allow any kind of barcode to be used with the PlantLog system. And it would also still let you use the standard barcodes as well. It just wouldn't make it mandatory. Okay, that's it for this tutorial. Be sure to watch other videos in this series which cover different aspects of the PlantLog software.